Right, hi guys. Right, this is a little informative video for yous. I don't know how many people out there know this. I dare say all the proper pros and that'll know this information. But if you're like me, well, when I first bought an Echo chainsaw, when I first purchased one, an Echo chainsaw, I had been using Husqvarnas and Stihls, a couple of Stihls, but the Husqvarna, I knew to grease the cage bearing, the needle bearing in the clutch, is basically because it's got the Husqvarna saws that I had the outside clutch, basically, not the clutch inside. Well, this is an inside internal clutch, whereas the Husqvarna one sticks out further, if you know. And the way to do it in a Husqvarna is this little tiny hole here. You put in that tiny hole and it basically, it's a cross drill on the actual crankshaft and it comes out to the needle bearing, and that's how you grease your needle bearings. I've got two Stihls, and I've actually had three or four Stihls. I had an 038, that's a 240, an MS240, and I have got a 660 in there, and none of the Stihls have that feature. But I've got three Echos. I've got my 4310, I've got my 501 SX, and I've got my 621 SX. And every one of those Echos has this feature. Would you put the your sprocket grease gun onto that, and it will catch the grease. When I first did it, my first Echo I had was my CS501. And for the longest time, I was actually taking off the clutch to get to it and to do the grease bearing. I didn't even notice eventually. I don't know how I noticed it, but I think it was through a mistake. I'd had this off for about 3 years, 4 years by the time I actually noticed. And I actually remember searching this up on YouTube, and there was no videos on this. There is for Husqvarnas and for stuff like that, but there wasn't any for Echos. Even in the operator's manual. Now I've got three operators manuals, I've got the 5011, the 4310 and the 621, and there is no mention of that on the operators manual, how to grease your needle bearing. How often would you do it? Well, let's say I use my saws for basically, I'd say 2 weeks solid every year. I've been doing it for 15 years. Sometimes, don't get me wrong, that's just a rough estimate. If I was full time, the full time use would be 2 to 3 weeks. Every year. That's how often I use my saws. So if I'm going out cutting, let's say, for 4 or 5 days in a row, I'll just sharpen the chains in between. If I need to clean it, I'll clean it. Normally when I'm finished at the end of the week and I'm going to put the saw away, I'll give the saw a good thorough clean down and I'll give it a couple of pumps. Don't overdo it, just give it a couple of pumps. So how often basically is mean it's less is more, I think. I think you can overdo it. If you do overdo it, you'll just get that in a mess inside. So just a general couple. What I tend to find is basically if I feel that spinning freely and I give it a couple of pumps and you can actually feel it start to get a wee bit stiffer because the grease is picking it up. It's picking up the grease. And that's how I normally gauge it. I normally give it like two to three pumps at the very most. And maybe, I would say after maybe 3-4 days use, do it again. Basically, a good way to think of it is when you clean the saw down, do that bearing. But anyway, that's just if you know this, you know this information. But if you were like me, searching on the internet how to actually do that to an Echo chainsaw, there's no information on it. So I found out by accident how to do it. So I'm just, if you know it, if you watch this video, oh, I know that. Well, that's good for you. You know it. But if you don't know it, you don't know it. This friend that doesn't know. Right. Anyway, guys. Right. Thanks. Bye.